anointing also is what mends the brokenhearted. The power, the anointing is the empowerment. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because He has empowered me to mend the brokenhearted. Do you? How many people know that when something is broken, to mend it is a big task? Mm-hmm. It can be mended, but it's a big problem. But the empowerment helps you to mend what is broken. Mm-hmm. Whatever is broken, whether it's your career, your relationship, whether it's your dream, it can be mended when the power is on and it can be restored. And I see whatever is broken in your life being mended in the name of Jesus Christ. I say, may they be mended in the name of Jesus Christ. So there's an empowerment to mend what is broken. Your broken relationship, broken dreams, they can all be mended through empowerment.
Amen.
The Spirit is upon me. May that Spirit will be upon you so that it can empower you and bring, the restoration of what is broken.
Amen.
He also said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me because He has anointed me to set the captives free.
Mm.
Yeah. There are people who are in captivity to drugs, to bad habits, addiction. They are in bondage, but they can be free when there is a release of power.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. They can be free. They can be free from addiction, from bondage, things that has held them, captive for a long time. Yeah. It just requires an empowerment. Yeah. Just require an empowerment. And that power is going to be released in the mighty name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. Yeah. Through the power of God. And He said, it has also, empower me to open the blind eyes. Mm-hmm. Yes. To preach, recovery to those who are lost. Recovery. Can recover your lost glory, lost opportunity. I'm talking to you about power upon. Power around, power what? Upon. But there's also the power within.
Amen.
We're talking about empowerment. The Spirit of God brings power. The power within, Job 32 verse 8. Job 32 verse 8 says, there is a spirit in man, and the inspiration of the Almighty giveth him what? Understanding. There is a spirit. So the Holy Spirit in you can release inspirational power.
Amen.
Inspirational power. Somebody say inspirational power.
Inspirational
power is the power for high level performance in life. Once you are inspired in life, you can perform at a higher level.
Amen.
You can perform what? At a higher level. Inspiration means stimulus. Something that stimulates you. Mm-hmm. It's a motivation. It's a creative power. It's a catalyst.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody say catalyst.
Catalyst.
It's like a kind of brilliance.
Mm-hmm.
It's a brilliance that is released. It's genius.
Mm-hmm.
Genius power. It's like the genie in the bottle. Something bigger. Something explosive happened once there's an inspiration. Say there's a spirit in man to inspire you.
Mm-hmm.
Inspiration is what helps you to perspire in life so that you don't retire, but you keep staying on fire until you acquire all your desires.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Amen.
The inspiration will keep you. The inspiration will inspire you so that you are what? You perspire and you don't retire, but you keep refiring until you acquire everything you desire. That inspiration, keeps you, gets you to be inspired, to perspire so that you can refire and not retire until you acquire all your desire. May you acquire your dreams,
Amen.
Acquire your desires
Amen.
By the inspiration power. May you be motivated.
Yes.
But it's the spirit within. Can I hear an amen?
Amen?
The spirit within. Yes. May that power be released in your life.
Amen.
Once the spirit is within you, it will help you to pray. The spirit helped us to pray. It helps our prayer. And what does prayer do for you? Prayer, when you pray, God said, call upon me, I will answer you, and I will show you great and mighty things. What will make you great and mighty is by the Spirit in you, leading you to the place of prayer.
Amen.
So that you can have a revelation, you can have inspiration from God, so that you can do great and mighty things. Can I prophesy? You begin to do great and mighty things in your life. I say you begin to do great and mighty things in your life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes. So, it's very powerful. I think it was Samson, you know, he was confronted by the Philistine, and the Bible said the Spirit of the Lord came mightily upon him. And he was so inspired that he took the jawbone of an ass and slew 1,000 men with the jawbone of an ass by the inspiration power that came. You know, when you are inspired, you can always find solution. You can always find answers to problems because you are stimulated. There's stimulus. You know, you are motivated. You know, there is creative power once there is inspiration. That's what the Holy Spirit. When you are filled with the Spirit of God, we're talking about being filled with the Spirit of God. You're going to be inspired to be creative. You're going to have creative power, finding solutions. You just look around. You're going to find what to do to solve your problem. May that become your lot and inheritance in the name of Jesus Christ.